hope you all are fine. Today I am going to explain you the science new topic of this week. Chapter that is on page number 18. You know that leaf is one of the most important part of the plant. Over here you will see the parts of the leaf, that is the midrib, that is the center part of the plant, side margin, tip, vein, petiola, stem, axil and leaf base. Now we will talk about that of the leaves are well suited for their job. What are the jobs the leaves are doing and how they are performing these jobs. They are broad and flat to absorb lot of light and exchange gases with the surrounding air. Many leaves are so broad and flat, so the more light will be absorbed on their surface. They are thin, so gas can get to all the cells easily. They have holes called stomata to let gases into and out from the surrounding air. They have lots of veins made from vascular bundle to carry water to photosynthesizing size cell and carry sugar away. Veins also help support the leaves. Okay, these all are the functions of the leaves, different parts of the leaf which are present, so performing different types of functions. Okay. Now I will explain you what is photosynthesis. You all know that making of food by the process of photosynthesis, the process of converting energy from the sun into chemical energy in the form of glucose, that is making of the food of the plant, is called as photosynthesis process. This is done by the green pigment that is called as the chlorophyll, which is present in the chloroplast of that of the leaf. Okay, what is cuticle? Plant retain water by having a waxy waterproof layer called a cuticle on their leaves and stem. The plant save their water by this cuticle. Because of this cuticle, the water will remain over there. Afterward, we will talk about the stromata. What do you mean by stromata? Pores in the leaf, mostly on the under surface. Each pore is surrounded by a pair of guard cells. Guard cells can change shape of the shape to open or close the stromata. Over here, you will see a open stromata. This is closed stromata, means water will go inside or come outside, and it will be closed afterwards. Okay, now we will talk transporting food, how the food will be transported. You will see sugar is used to provide energy for growing shoot. Sugar is stored in the root as a starch. Fruit stores sugar, that is why they taste sweet. Okay, sugar move up and down the stem in phloem tube. The root need sugar to give them energy and growth. These all are the functions why the food is being transferred to all parts of the plant. This is the process how sugar flows through a plant. Number one, cell in the growing shoot use sugar in respiration. For respiration, cell need that of the glucose. Leaves make sugar by photosynthesis. The sugar mixed with water to make a strong sugar solution. Okay, then what happened? Sugar solution move from cell. Sugar move up and down the stem in phloem tube. The root need sugar to give them energy and growth. These all are the functions why the food is being transferred to all parts of the plant. This is the process how sugar flows through a plant. Number one, cell in the growing shoot use sugar in respiration. For respiration, cell need that of the glucose. Leaves make sugar by photosynthesis. The sugar mixed with water to make a strong sugar solution. Okay, then what happened? Sugar solution moved from cell to cell along the phloem tube. Sugar goes into the root and shoot and is used in respiration. Last thing, cell in root use sugar in respiration or store it as starch. Okay, in the form of starch, the sugar is being stored. Okay. Now, what is osmosis? In biology, the net movement of water molecules through the cell membrane from an area of higher to an area of the lower water potential or water concentration is called as osmosis. That the water will move from the higher concentration towards the lower concentration, this is called as osmosis. okay, more detailed description of that of osmosis, but what water moves from the higher concentration of water, less salt or sugar dissolved in it, to a lower concentration of water, more salt or sugar dissolved in it. This means that water would cross a selectively permeable membrane from a dilute solution, less dissolved in it, to a concentrated solution, more dissolved in it. Means it is moving from where it is needed, okay, it will move from the higher concentration. If it is in the higher concentration, so it will move towards where there is needed in the low concentration area by the semi-permeable membrane, that is called as the osmosis. These are the questions which you have to complete in your biology copy. What happened at the root tip? What is the job of the root cap? What do leaves do? What are leaf veins? What are they for? Explain why narrow leaves still do their job well. What make a leaf waterproof? Explain why the upper skin of the leaf is transparent. Why do the cell in the middle of the leaf have lots of chloroplast? Why do growing shoot need sugar? Why do fruit taste sweet? What is osmosis? Explain why osmosis is a simple special kind of diffusion. What is partially permeable membrane? Okay, these all are the questions which you have to complete in your biology copy.